We are waiting for more results to be announced from Nevada and Arizona. Here's where the races stand as of now. Both states remain close. In Nevada, less than one percentage point is separating the candidates. 89% of the vote is in. And in Arizona, Joe Biden has a slight edge over President Trump with 86% of the vote in. For more on this, I want to bring in CBS News correspondent Enrique Acevedo. He is in Las Vegas. And CBS News campaign reporter Alex Tin. He is in Phoenix. All right. Thank you both for being with us. Enrique, what is the latest update on the ballot counting there in Nevada?
We do have some new information for you, Elaine. Nevada's Secretary of State says they are a little over 190,000 outstanding ballots. And the most interesting part about that information is that 90% of them are being counted right here in Clark County. This is where the voting is happening. It's a laborious process. They're taking their time. If we had a soundtrack to describe what's happening here in Nevada, it would sound a lot like Despacito, very slowly. But accuracy is the goal here, not speed. So the margin in counted votes between both candidates stands at around 11,438 votes in advantage of Joe Biden.
Well, Alex, what about Arizona? What is the latest on the count there?
Well, it's interesting. Compared to Nevada, Arizona is really in the home stretch when it comes to counting ballots here. You know, Nevada has this postmark deadline where voters can cast their ballots at a mailbox as long as it's postmarked by Election Day. And essentially, elections officials have to keep the polls, the mail polls, open 7 days after Election Day to accept as many mail ballots as show up, you know, with that Election Day postmark. That's not the case in Arizona. There is a finite number of remaining ballots left to be counted, and counties all across the state are churning away as they whittle down that final remaining number of ballots to be counted. There's already an overwhelming share of the votes, you know, tabulated here in Arizona. I think it's nearing close to 90% last time I checked of the expected vote turnout. And I'm sure very soon, at 7 p.m. local time today, we'll be seeing the next batch of results right here in Maricopa County, which could be a pivotal moment in terms of deciding this race in this state.
Absolutely. Well, Enrique, the Trump campaign is adding Nevada to their list of states with legal challenges. They are saying they will sue over an alleged 10,000 voters who no longer live in the state. What can you tell us about that claim?
Unfortunately, very little, Elaine. Representatives from the Trump campaign and Republicans here in Nevada called a press conference earlier today. We were there to announce this lawsuit, but they didn't take any questions. We asked them about when and where they were planning to file the lawsuit. They didn't answer that question. They did not provide any evidence about what they called improper ballots. We asked Clark County officials about that, and they say that they're not aware of any improper ballots being counted.
Well, Alex, is the Trump campaign considering any legal action there in Arizona?
Well, actually, Elaine, just minutes ago in a state court here in Arizona, the Trump campaign moved to intervene in a case over a, as if you ask local officials, conspiracy theory about whether using Sharpies at the ballot box invalidated voters' ballots. Now, again, just to be clear, local officials, state officials, they both say not only was using Sharpies at ballot boxes in order to fill out their ballots allowed, but it was encouraged. It reduces the likelihood that ballots get smudged when they're read through the scanner. Nevertheless, there is a vocal and small group of voters here in this state who say that their votes were invalidated because they use Sharpies, and at least one of them has filed a suit in state court that the Trump campaign, as well as the state Democratic Party here, has now been granted permission to intervene in.
All right. That is some new developments there where you are. Enrique, CBS News estimates that these states are likely going to Biden. What would winning these two states mean for his campaign?
Well, that's a ballgame, Elaine. If he wins in Nevada and Arizona, those are 13 electoral votes that take Joe Biden to the coveted 270 electoral votes required to win the presidency. So you can see why both campaigns are competing for every vote in Arizona and here in Nevada also, Elaine.
All right, Enrique Acevedo and Alex Tin, there you see the map. Thank you both very much. Really appreciate it.